हेलो हेलो हेलो
हेलो हेलो ओके, आई विल स्टार्ट विद द इंट्रोडक्शन. कैन यू एबल टू सी द दिस पीडीएफ?
यस मैम
प्लीज म्यूट योर माइक्रोफोन्स एंड स्टे अवे फ्रॉम दिस साउंड, सो अदरवाइज इट विल एको मी बैक. ओके, इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव सीन दी इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव सीन दी द प्रोबेबिलिटी, इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द प्रोबेबिलिटी एंड द बेस थ्योरम. जस्ट वट एवर इट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट, जस्ट आई एम गोइंग थ्रू वंस अगेन. यू नो दी वट इज द प्रोबेबिलिटी? इट इज अ मैथमेटिकल टूल यूज बाई इंजीनियर्स टू अंडरस्टैंड एंड डिस्क्राइब द इफेक्ट्स ऑफ नॉन डिटर्मिनिस्टिक एप्लीकेशन. ओके, वेन दैट इज नॉन डिटर्मिनिस्टिक means you don't know the you can't predict the what is the output, and also you have seen the sample space and events. Okay, and the random experiment. Random experiment, an experiment is called a random experiment if its outcome cannot be predicted. And the sample space, it is all possible outcomes of a random experiment. Example, it is like an universal set. And also one more point is an element in an S is called a sample point. If an example, if you toss a coin, what are the possible outcomes? That is head and tail. So each element, that is head and the tail, are called as the sample point. Head is one sample point and tail is one sample point. And events. Events is any subset of the sample space. S is called an event. That means if I toss a coin, possible outcomes are head and tail, and I will define the event such that if I toss a two coins simultaneously, that is our possible outcomes will be HH, HT, TH and TT. So in this, what I will define an event is, that is, S is number of hits occurring at least equal to one. Then that is called as an event. Sometimes whole sample space itself is then the output of a random experiment. Then S is often called as a certain event. Okay. And also we have seen the algebra of sets, equality, complementation, union, intersection, null set, and disjoint sets. A disjoint set, this is important. Two sets and A and B are called disjoint or mutually exclusive if they contain no common elements. That is, A intersection B is equal to null set. Okay, and also we have seen the what these are the you know already you know this commutative law, associative law, de Morgan's, this one, and also we have seen the axioms of probability, and this all we have seen always. That is, probability of sample space is equal to one, and this also we have seen, and this also we have seen A union B is equal to probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A intersection of B. If it is a null set, then what happens? This will be equal to sum of the only two events. Next, very, very important is this one and the base rule. That's why I'm doing this recap of this. Okay. And conditional probability. Conditional probability, that is, event occurs on the depends on the some condition. The conditional probability of event A is A. Given event B, it is denoted by A slash B. That is, event A depends on B. That's equal to probability of A intersection of B and the denominator is this one, P of B is, and where this is called as a joint probability. Joint probability means that is a A intersection of B. Similarly, if the event B depends on A, then that is given as probability of actually B intersection of A divided by this new denominator P of A. Both are equal. P probability of B intersection of A is equal to probability of A intersection of B. So you can remember this. From this above expression, what we can write is, because P of A intersection B is equal to probability of A bar B into probability of B, and also this is equal to probability of B bar A into probability of A. How you can remember is, probability A bar B denominator, B bar A denominator. And from this, we are going to define this base theorem, and that is A bar B is equal to what? P of B bar of A, probability of A divided by this denominator. Okay, P of B. If it is P of B bar A, then it is you have to write the ulta. P of A bar B into P of B divided by this denominator P of B. Somehow you have to remember this equation. This is ulta, you can see. This is denominator, and this is probability of this denominator, you can remember. Next is total probability. That also we have seen. So if the events A1, A2, A3 are all mutually exclusive, then this partition of all this I is equal to n, it is sum of all the events is equal to what? So whole sample space. Let B be an event in S, then probability of B is equal to probability of B intersection of AI such that I is equal to 1 to n. This can be written as B intersection can be written as B bar AI conditional probability into this numerator. Okay, using this, this is known as total probability of event B. P of B is conditional probability depending on A into probability of AI. And by using this, this base theorem can be written as, because base theorem is conditional AI slash B is equal to this of ulta into P of AI divided by this probability of B. Now I will replace this probability of B with the same thing, with the summation, same as numerator. You can observe this, same as this numerator, only we have to include the summation. So this is, because in some times we are going to use the this formula, so you should remember. And independent events, two events A and B are said to be independent, statistically independent, if and only if, that is P of probability of A intersection B is equal to, that is probability of A into B. That means occurrence of one event doesn't depend on the occurrence of the other events. So if probability of A on condition B, if it is an independent event, it does not depend on the B. Whatever may be the probability of B, I don't mind. I will consider only the probability of A. Similarly, your probability of B by A is equal to probability of B. And also one blindly you can remember is, whenever the intersection is there, you can go for the product P of A into P of B. Okay, this is important for the to understand the next topic. Okay, Next, I will. Okay, now we will see the random variables. Okay, so you can see before going for the random variables, so I will explain one example and you will learn. I will go for the this explanation or the definition. Okay, in the experiment of tossing a coin once, we define random variable X, is a capital X, and I will write if this does, then we will add in some number, let it be 1. X is what? It is a random number, and H is your observation. So X of H is 1, and the X of if it is tail, then I will assign 0. X of t is equal to 0. Note, always you note that random variable is defined in a capital X. And also, it always it may not be in 1 and 0. It might be 0 and 1 with the other variable. Note that you could also define the another random variable. See, y or z with y of is equal to 0 and y of t, that is tail, is equal to 1. Okay, that means what I am doing for a random variable, I am assigning some numeric value, is it not? So it is some real numbers I am assigning. Okay, some real number I am assigning, and later I will explain this. Now I will take an example, and here now in the sample space for a given experiment is not a unique. It depends on is selecting three defective ICs out of 10. I will select your is defined as selecting the, that is your experiment is selecting the three defective ICs simultaneously. I have to pick the simultaneously means I have to pick one on the other, one after the other. Both possibility of getting the three defective ICs. Okay, if I write the sample space, all are NN defines the non-defective ICs. Here NN, that means I will not get even a single defective IC, or NND, that is I will get the one defective IC at the third time. And here NDN, that is I will get the defective IC second time. Similarly, when I write this, my sample space will be like this: NDD and DNN, DND and DDN and trilogy. Okay, that means in the last case, all are defective ICs. Okay, next I will define a random variable such that it indicates the defective items. Okay, now I will write the, this is, I will call it as lambda 1. This either this is a sample point or it S1. S1, that is each possible outcomes of sample space, I am calling it as sample point. This is, see here we have seen that these are the sample points.
Your voice is breaking, ma'am. Ma'am, your voice is breaking.
Hello. Oh, still not breaking.
Yes, ma'am, it is breaking.
Please ask, mute your you this one. Like all countries stay away away from disturbance, TV and other disturbance. Now can you hear me properly?
No, ma'am.
Okay, one second. I will adjust this speaker volume. Hello, hello. Now, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Till now, you understood whatever I told, like you understood sample point and understood the this one, that is. Selecting the three defective ICs, selecting a three, understood this experiment, random experiment?
Yes,
Hello? Okay, then now I will define X as a random variable such that it indicates the defective items. Now I will define x of s1, it is a sample point, where that is x of, what is that sample point? N, that is all or non-defective ICs. But my, I am defining it as defective items, so that is equal to 0. So no defective item. So that means I am assigning 0 to this sample point. Okay, next. X of S2, that is one defective item. In this, can you tell me which are the sample points or one defective item? This one, two. Yes, next. Can anyone items? Is S2, one more is? Yes, can you tell still any other are there? Yes? Yes? Anyone can answer? Can yes, two.
And your yes, voice three, is breaking. And it might be network issue with you.
Hello, hello. Now can you hear me? Because that's some network issue. Hello.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Hello.
Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, here I am taking all sample points. S2, S3, and S5. So N and D, this one. Okay. For if in my sample points, if defective item is 1, then I am assigning a number 1 to this. If there are the two defective items, so there are the two defective items. These are the NDD, S4, S6, and S7. These are the and here X of S8, three defective items only. This is S8, sample point is equal to 3. Here, what you have to observe is I am assigning a number to a random variable. That you keep in mind. And also you see that there is an, this is unique and this is unique. That is one-to-one correspondence. But here, when the number 1 is there, here it is mapped to the three sample points. Here, many to one function. You observe that. Now, I am introducing one more word, that is range of space. Yes, X. That is, what is the range of the space of random variable X? Here, what is the range space of the random variable? This is 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay. This is random variable. Always we are denoting it what? With the numbers. Understood this point? Yes? Yes. Please, you understood this. Yes, have you
Yes,
understood?
ma'am.
Okay. Now I will go for the random variable definition. Random variable is a function that assigns a real number called an observation to each outcome in S. It is denoted as capital X of A is equal to small x A. Here x A is what? X A is what? You have seen the example. What is this small x A? Small x is what? Hello? Hello? Here small x is what? Or
range of
you
all
didn't
observations.
understand or what? No, that is a some real number. XA is some real number. What you have to understand is here, random variable, it is always assigned with a real number. Okay. And that is XA is real number. That's what we have defined the 0, 1 and 2. And here we have the this sample space. Again, we have taken the example of ICs, A, B, C here. But in the our case, we have eight sample points. And those sample points are assigned to what? That is a real time axis. That is a real number. Let me call it as XA and XB. And we have seen that with no defective items, it is unique. But if it is a one defective items, it is many to one function. B and C are mapped to one value. That is what they have explained. And XX is what? That is a range of space. That is here in this case, it is XA and XB. In our selecting in the IC, it was, what is the range? 0, 1, 2, and 3. Understood? Yes, you understood what is the random variable?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, that's what you have. Okay. Next, you have learned two things. What is random variable? Always it is defined with what? Capital X or small x? Hello? Random variable means what? Always it is denoted with
capital X.
Why I am repeating again and again is these are very, very important. Okay. And next is range of one more I have defined is range of sample X, that is SX. Okay. Yes, X defines the random variable. It might be in SY also. Okay. So in the, again, one more example, in the experiment of tossing a coin, we define the random variable 1, x of h as 1 and 0. Now, can you tell me what is the range space here? Range
0,
space 0, 1. Okay. Next is events defined by the random variable. Okay. So here, please, you know that is in our selecting the items of IC, we have defined the events, X is less than or equal to 2. That is what I am defining a event, that is defective items, that is less than or equal to 2. Here, that is how it can be defined as lambda, some sample point, and that sample point assigned with some real number. Okay, that is what they have defined. Okay, and that sample point may take the value from minus infinity to plus infinity. What the your random variable range. Okay, so that is what we have seen this with this example. Okay. Here and mathematically how this event is written as it is greater than, usually we will use the relational symbol, that is greater than or equal to, less than or equal to, and this real number, and that is an event. If it is a probability of X is equal to 2, then it is yes, sample space x of 2 is equal to 2, and this small s belongs to your capital S. That is, sample point belongs to sample space. Example, p is equal to x is equal to 2. This is what is the probability of this 2 defective items. Similarly, all this is defined. Okay. Next is very, very important, that is distribution function. Okay. So generally you have understood the event when we assign a probability to a random variable, then it is called as a distribution function or cumulative distribution function, that is CDF of X. So always only if you consider the random variable, it is not a probability, it is only a real number we are assigning. When we apply the probability to that random variable, then it will become distribution function or a cumulative distribution function, CDF. Okay. So how we are assigning this? That is denoted by capital F. X, capital X is random variable X, and this small x. That is what probability of X less than or equal to X. Please you make, don't read, always why what I suggest now or recommend is always while studying, please practice, because otherwise it will make a confusion, capital X and this one. Okay. Please while writing exam, you, it will create a lot of this one, though you understood, please you practice writing. And also you remember when the capital X and when small x. And here small x, that real number varies between minus infinity to plus infinity, or it is defined as probability of some sample point I am defining, and this is equal to X, or it is easy to remember this, you can remember. So whenever, that is whenever the probability is applied to a random variable, then that will become your CDF. Okay. So then before going to the this properties of this CDF, we will see the one example and we will understand, and we will then we will see once again the this definition and the this properties. Okay. In the experiment of tossing a fair coin 3 times, the sample space S consists of 8 equally likely sample points. If X is the random variable giving the number of heads obtained, then find probability of X is equal to 2. The second one is probability of X is less than 2. Now, what is your sample space? When you tossing a fair coin 3 times, it is the possibility. First time when you toss, you may get head, second time head, third time head, and the next when you repeat the experiment, first 2 times head and the T. And I hope you have understood this, how to write the all the sample space. Now, what they are asking is, what is the probability of X is equal to 2? X is equal to 2. What is the probability of X is equal to 2? Can you tell me from the sample space? Exactly equal to 2. No, no. Here you see, you tell the sample space here. Which are the?
HHT.
Yes. THH. Okay. This P of X is equal to, this is the sample points. And since the sample points are equally likely occurs, all 3 are, that is 1 by 8 they will occur. So it is 1 by 8 plus 1 by 8 plus 1 by 8. It is 3 by 8. Similarly, I will calculate probability of x is less than 2. Then your please you have to observe this, whether they have given less than or equal to. Please you have to observe that. And here from the sample space, it is less than 2. Even all 3 times 3, it is also in less than 2. So then we will get the, that is 4/8. Okay, now I will write the this. Okay, this is x is an capital X is an random variable, and here I am defining the event. What is my event? That is numbering occurrence of 0. So here the number of occurrence of -1. No, there is no 4. This is null set. And if it is less than 0, this is t, and you know that that is less than or equal to 1, this is, and corresponding probability have written probability of x less than or equal to x, null set 0, this is 1/8, this is 1/2, and this is 7/8, and it is x less than or equal to 3. Yes, less than or equal to 3. What is your this one? What are your outcomes or your sample points? Whole S will come for the this sample points. Then it is HH less than or equal to. So whole sample point itself is an event now. Okay. So then your probability it is 1. Even if I go on extending this x to the x less than or equal to 4, it is whole sample space, and it is less than or equal to 5, it is whole samples. If I write the, that is what you have to understood is CDF, cumulative distributive function, is when probability is assigned to a random number, then it will become cumulative distributive function, and it is denoted by capital F and random variable x. Okay, and if I write this is x, then I have to write when it is x less than 0, it is 0. When x is equal to 1, it is 1/8. Here I am writing this is 1/8, 2/8, 3/8, and up to 1. And when it is x less than or equal to 1, it is 4/8. Similarly, when it is x is less than or equal to 2, it is at or equal to 2, it is 7/8. Then x is less than or equal to 3, holds 3, it was here, next it is jumped to 1. So here after that it will stay. This is what your cumulative distributive function. Understood this? Yes. Please understand what is cumulative distributive function. Have you understood this? Whatever I explain now?
I explain now.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, shall I repeat?
No need, ma'am.
Okay, you understood? Okay. Next is here, I will see the what are the properties of cumulative distributive function. When the probability it is assigned, what is the range of probability? You know that that will be 0 to 1. That is what we have written, 0 less than, that means your cumulative distributive function always ranges between 0 and 1. And the second point is f of cumulative distributive function of x1 is less than or equal to cumulative distributive function of x2 if x1 is less than x2. That we can observe here, that is x1 it is 1/2 and here it is 7/2. Always this is okay, that we have to observe less than or equal to if x1 is less than x2. And then the limit of cumulative distributive function as small x limits tends to infinite, then the value of your cumulative distributive function is equal to 1. And if it is cumulative distributive function value as the x tends to minus infinity, this is nothing but the 0. Okay. Understood this? Distributive function is when the probabilities are assigned to a random variable, that will become your distributive function. Okay. Next is discrete random variables and probability mass function PMF. Okay. Here I'm using the one more word, that is PMF, that is probability mass function. Okay, till now you know the random variable CDF. Okay, now I am introducing, and also you know that is a random variable. Variable may be in discrete and continuous. Here you are going to study both the variables. Now what is the discrete? You know the meaning of that discrete. And here probability mass function. One more word, that is probability mass function, we will see. Okay, before going for this definition, we will see the example. Okay, just let x be a random variable with CDF. CDF, it is defined with the capital F of x. If f of x changes values only in jumps and is constant between the jumps, then x is called as a discrete random variable. Usually we may use the discrete random variable DRV. Alternatively, it can be discrete random. X is a discrete random variable only if its range contains a finite or countably infinite number of points. What do you mean by countable infinite number of points? Between 1 and 2, it is discrete only. Because when you divide this thing, still you can measure. There are between, if I take this numbers 1 to 2, here there is so many possible infinite numbers are there. That's what, but still I can count. That is finite or countably infinite number of the points. Example, they are giving tossing a pair of coin once, sample points is equal to HT. Tossing a pair of coin twice, this is your sample point. And tossing a fair coin repeatedly and counting the number of tosses required until the first head appears. So you are repeating so many number of times, that is sample space. And here it is countably finite and it is countably infinite. That means many, you will repeat the experiment many times, but still it is countable. Okay. Probability mass function PMF. What is that? Okay. Suppose define this mathematical equation, then I will go. This is f of x cumulative distributive function of xi minus cumulative distribution function of x of I minus 1 is nothing but probability of x less than or equal to xi minus probability of x less than or equal to xi minus 1. Now we will relate this with this equation. Okay, so what is that? And that will be equal to what? Probability of x is equal to xi. Okay, now I will take small xi as 2. What is the cumulative distributive function of value with xi is equal to 2 minus cumulative distributive function value of 1? 2 minus 1, it is 1. Okay, then what is this? Probability of x is less than or equal to xi. What is probability of less than x is equal to 2? X is equal to 2. It is 7 by 8. And minus, what is the probability of x less than or equal to 1? It is 4 by 8. What is the difference? 7 by 4 minus 4 by 8 is equal to 3 by 8. That's what they are telling. It is equal to probability of x is equal to 2 in my case. Now we will see with this. X is equal to 2. What is this? This 7 by 8 minus of this 4 by 8. This is what they were 3 by 8. Understood? Yes? Hello? Have you understood?
Yeah, that is.
Understood this? I hope you have understood this probability mass function. That is f of x, cumulative distributive function value f of xi minus of previous value is nothing but probability of this value minus of probability of random variable less than or equal to x of I minus 1. This is equal to probability of x is equal to xi. Suppose, now I am doing here, suppose that the jumps in cumulative distribution function x of a discrete random variable x occur at the points x1, x2 and x3 where the sequence may be either finite or countably infinite, and we assume xi is less than xj if I is less than j. So then it is also written as probability of x is equal to x is nothing but the probability of x, or probability of x, right, can be denoted as a random variable and x. It is here the function p of x or p of x is called the probability mass function. What you can observe is that is the equal sign for a discrete random variable. From the example of tossing a fair coin 3 times and a random variable x is giving the number of heads obtained, sample space you know, probability of p of x is equal to 0. What is that x is equal to 0? T, that is 1 by 8. Can you tell me probability of x is equal to 1? You can see that probability of x is equal to 1. How I'm calculating this 4 by 8 minus of 1 by 8. That is nothing but 3 by 8. Or till here I am not writing less than or equal. You observe this in the PMF. I am writing only the equals. Okay. And here probability of x is equal to 2 is is 1 by 8. Okay, now we will understood this. What is PMF? And when you add all this, what is the value you are going to get? What is the summation of all the PMFs? Can you add and tell
me?
One. So now when you see this properties, always your probability of x will xi or x is equal to 1. You can see that it is between the 0 and 1. And all the summation of probability of xi, x is equal to 0, 1, 2 and 3, the summation is equal to 1. Now the CDF is capital F of x of a discrete random variable can be obtained by if x of x is equal to p x less than or equal to x is equal to summation. Understood this? Okay. And now note, for any this probability mass function, a random variable x has to be in discrete random variable and operator has to be equals, because PMF is, that is probability mass function, it is always associated with discrete random variable. For continuous random variable, one, we have a one more term called probability density function. Probability mass function, it is discrete random variable. Okay, understood? What is PMF? Till now we have learnt CDF, PMF and the random variable. Yes, one of you can, in 1 minute, can you summarize what is CDF and what is PMF? Yes, quickly. What is random variable? Whatever you till now, you understood. Yes, because all three chapters will be like this only. You have to understand this CDF, PDF, all this. Yes, can one of you can repeat what is random variable? What you know, one, some, you somewhere you had to remember. How will you remember random variable always associated with random, this one, real numbers? Yes, next, CDF. CDF, can you tell me when it is CDF? Hello? Yes, through charts also you can. Yes. Hello. I will ask anyone here. Srihari, can you tell me what is CDF? Hello. Hello. Are you there? Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, you tell me. What is CDF? When it is called CDF? When the probability is assigned,
is
to,
assigned to a probability of random variable less than 1.
No, no, no. CDF is what? Please mute your microphones. And here, whenever probability is assigned to a random variable, then it is a CDF. Okay. And probability mass function, it is associated with discrete random variable. And that is always the operator will be equal to X. Please, you go through the all these whatever I explain now, and please be thorough. This, okay. Next, I will go with the continuous random variable. Okay, continuous random variable, and here we are dealing with probability density function. Probability mass function is associated with your discrete random variable. Here, probability density function is for the continuous random variable. Okay. Example, find the sample space for the experiment of measuring lifetime in hours of a transistor. Clearly, all possible outcomes are all non-negative real numbers, that is S. How we are going to write it is, S is equal to T and 0, your sample space will be like this. Not a discrete, here it is continuous. Okay, it may be any microseconds or something like that. So it is time, it is continuous. So we are measuring a lifetime of a transistor. When where T represent the life of transistor in hours, hence the sample space is continuous. Next, definition of continuous random variable. Let X be a random variable with CDF if X of X, if this cumulative distributive function is continuous and also has a derivative, that is d by dx of cumulative distribution function, which exists everywhere except at possibly a finite number of points and is piecewise continuous, then X is called a random variable. So here probability density function is what? Derivative of your CDF. Understood? Derivative of your cumulative CDF. Yes. If probability density function is given, how will you calculate CDF? Can anyone can tell me with this, by observing this equation? If this is given, probability, yeah, and also one more thing, probability density function, it is denoted by small f, cumulative capital F. If PDF is given, how will you calculate the CDF? Yes, anyone can tell here observing this equation?
By equating PDF to zero.
No, here you see, this is PDF is differentiation of CDF. Obviously your CDF will be what?
Integration
of PDF.
Integration of that PDF. You have to remember these things. Okay, PDF is differentiation of your CDF. CDF is integration of your PDF. Okay, and the properties of PDF, it is always that, and also it is small f. This always PDF is greater than or equal to zero, and the area under the curve minus infinity to plus infinity, integration of f of x dx is equal to 1, and it is piecewise continuous. If it is, that is continuous means I will take in between a to b, then it is a and b. See here, it is a less than b, x less than or equal to b. And the CDF capital F of x of a random variable x can be obtained. This, how will you obtain this? Is CDF is nothing but probability with this x less than x means minus infinity to x and f of x, okay, into d tau. Okay, so understood. Now next is, this is in a continuous random variable. So here it is, what is the probability of a in between x, random variable in between a and b? How will you obtain between a and b? It is f of x, cumulative distribution function of b, integration. So then minus this a, because these are all important, they will give the problems on this. Okay, f x of this PDF is by itself is not a probability, only when the function is integrated between the two limits, it is probability. Understood this point? Okay, next we will, in the next class we will see the problems. Okay, till now you understood? What you have understood is CD, you have to concentrate on random variable, CDF, PDF, and PMF associated with discrete random variable, PDF associated with continuous random variable, and the integration of this PDF gives the your CDF. When the and also you have to go through the all the properties. Please, for this you understand, also you please you practice, so then only you are able to solve the problems. Okay, I will continue in the next class. Have you understood today's class?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I will forward the notes. I will upload in the Edmodo. If not possible, I will send to your CR. Okay. Okay, thank you.